Hey guys, today we're reacting to Nex, some of his prank videos. His real name is like nextraker. I don't know how to say it. I think it's nextraker.
This video is for those of you looking for prank ideas for April 1st. I'm going to show you 5 simple pranks you can do. Let's start with grabbing your friend's windshield squeegee. First, you'll pry it open like you see here. And then unscrew it. It helps if the handle is hollow from the inside. Either way, you'll need to make a hole with a drill or a soldering iron.
This is actually your next editor's channel. The last one was prank completions. This one's actually his channel. Because, you know, can't be safe on the internet anymore. Yep, this one's actually next editor. Yeah, I've never seen his face before.
Last summer, I posted a video saying I'd do a face reveal. It was supposed to be a 2-part video, but I only uploaded the first part, which was mainly a teaser. The second part was never released, and I don't plan on doing a face reveal anymore due to people messing up my plans, which is cool because my channel is not about showing my face. It's not about me vlogging about current events. No, my channel is pranks, hacks, and random how-to videos, as well as some drawings. If you want to see other people talk in front of the camera, go elsewhere. Sorry if you subscribed for the face reveal. It won't happen, so you can now hit the unsub button. All those that are here for my DIY and tutorials on how to set up pranks, then you're at the right place. With that being said, please don't ask me for a face reveal.
Hey!
I dropped those plans months ago. I left a post on Facebook, but since not a lot of people follow me on there, I kept getting requests to do a face reveal. So hopefully now you know, and you'll stop asking. I appreciate all the support from my true fans and followers. After 7 years, we're still here. More videos on the way.
That sucked. Guess we'll listen to... this one's gonna help you guys a lot. It's 5 school hacks you can do when you're hungry. How to sneak food into class. But we're gonna do not that one. We're gonna do that one next. We're gonna do back to school pranks. Oh, crap. Okay, I guess we'll do how to sneak this stuff in to class when you're hungry.
What's up, Prankster? How's it going? Now, in this video, I'm going to do something totally different, something that I normally don't do anymore, which I know I should because my channel is about pranks and hacks, but I haven't done hacks lately, so I'm going to show you 5 of them that you can do in class. Now, these are not meant to get you into trouble. I'm actually trying to help you guys for next time. Let's say you wake
Thank
up
you.
Late and you rush to get to class and you skip breakfast and obviously you don't get to eat anything during class, and most teachers won't let you eat in class. Now, I'm not saying go and break the rules, but come on, man, you can't really learn anything on an empty stomach, right?
True.
So you gotta eat. So I'm gonna make it easier for you guys and show you a few ways that you can sneak food into class. Check it out. Alright, let's get started with our first one. And for all these hacks, you're gonna need school supplies. So, for example, this first hack, you're gonna need a glue stick. Preferably a large glue stick like this one, not the thin ones, because with this container, you can actually fit in more stuff in there. So, we're gonna use a large glue stick. So, begin to open it. As you can see, it's white. So, we're just gonna twist it all the way till it goes to the very top. And once it gets to that very top, you can actually remove it. And this actually, when you twist it, it goes up and down. So you're actually just gonna have to get rid of the glue stick, but you're gonna have to save this. So just get a paper towel and break it off. And of course, you're gonna have some residue, which you will need to remove also because we want this to be super clean. Of course, glue sticks aren't toxic, so you know, you can just clean it off. It's not gonna kill you if you were to eat this stuff. I'm not saying you're gonna eat this stuff. I'm just saying that if you were to eat it or consume it, it wouldn't kill you. So try to wipe it off clean. And also the inside, you're going to have to clean off. Now, once you're done cleaning it off, you're only going to need the cap, the base that actually twists on there, and then, of course, the container of the glue stick. This is the most important one. Now, this is where you get creative and think of something that you can actually stick in there, something that you can eat later on, such as a snack or a piece of candy. You know, next time you're hungry, next time you skip breakfast, and obviously you're on an empty stomach, so you're going to need calories. And for me, what better way to get those calories than with some chocolate? And these are my favorite right here, Reese's. I've not really tried these mini cups, but I'm guessing they're just as good as the big ones. And the reason why I chose these is because they're white. I don't know if the camera can capture the color, but they're white. The best part is that they actually fit inside perfectly. Look, you can see it's like a white color.
That's so, I see where he's going with this.
Okay, so just twist the base on there again, like that.
Pause the video right now.
So
you know what I'm talking about. Comment down below what you think I'm talking about. And then you can unpause the video. Do it now. Okay, guys. If you pause the video, sorry that I was silent for a few seconds, but whatever. Anyways, we're gonna go back.
A couple of Reese's mini cups in there, like this. Twist it so it goes down, and once it goes down, the stick inside in the center is gonna obviously it's gonna be in the way. So you're just gonna push the mini cups so that it pierces through. Keep stacking more in there. You can actually fit about 4 or 5, depending on how big the glue stick is. So twist down, and then push down. And then keep doing it until the whole glue stick's filled up. All right, so I was able to fit in 4. Possibly 5.
Sorry, if the video is making you hungry. You better go eat.
As you can see, it looks like a normal glue stick, right, guys? Watch. Compare it to the other one. Can you guys tell the difference?
Yeah, obviously, a little bit.
You won't be able to tell unless you already knew beforehand. So anyways, you just put the cap on. And then, save it in class. So obviously, don't eat it right away. This will be like a backup. This will be your actual glue stick, so you just know which one is which. But yeah, guys, save this as your backup. And next time you're hungry and you skip lunch or you just need one of these, you just reach into your desk and, grab this, take it out, and then just push up. You'll have one. You eat this one pretty good, and then you twist it back up. It looks like a broken glue stick. Yet they still won't be able to tell it's actual chocolate. And the thing with this is that it won't attract any bugs because it's sealed. So this is like the perfect way to stash your chocolates inside your desk. And again, your teachers or your classmates won't be able to tell that this is not actual glue, that it's actual chocolate. So yeah, guys, let me know what you guys think. I hope you guys like this hack.
That's actually pretty good. You should try that.
Now, most teachers won't allow you to have any drinks in
class. If you're just gonna get in trouble.
So if you like Gatorade, Powerade,
my teacher doesn't let me have water.
You can't have that in class. And I'm sure I know why. Because if you
have it during class,
it's stinky, it's harder to clean off, especially if there's carpet in the classroom. So yeah, I can understand that.
My teacher doesn't let me do that.
Sometimes you just gotta have this stuff to actually get the sugar to boost up your energy for the day. So a good way to sneak this into class is to actually sneak it into a glue bottle. Yeah, I know it sounds crazy, but it actually works. This is a non-toxic glue, so if you were to eat this, it's not gonna get you sick, it's not gonna kill you, but it does taste kind of nasty because, I think we've all tasted it as kids. I don't know. Who knows? Mm-hmm. I kind of did at some point. Anyway,
so
you have to empty out this glue bottle. Empty it out. You can save it into a bag or something so it does not go to waste. But as you can see, you have to get rid of all of it. The most important part about this hack, and then the most vital one, is that you clean it very well.
Continue
so take it to
the
sink and spray out all that glue that's still in there.